Federal health officials consider it an epidemic, yet you rarely hear a thing about it. At first, it seemed to strike only one segment of the population. Now, Barry Peterson tells us this is no longer the case.
It was devastating, you know. At that time, I was 29 years old. To be told that I had cancer was just, it turned me around.
Bobbi Campbell is fighting for his life, one of a rapidly growing group whose battle has fascinated and frightened modern medicine. He has Kaposi sarcoma, a deadly skin cancer that first appeared on the bottom of his feet as spots the size of a quarter. There is a 1 in 5 chance a victim will die within the first year of the illness. It's a disease first detected in the gay community that has now spread beyond that, a disease experts are now calling a national epidemic.
There are more lives claimed, victims claimed, than toxic shock and Legionnaire's disease combined. And yet most of the country doesn't know about this cancer.
Why?
Well, I think it's because it's a gay cancer.
It appeared a year ago in New York's gay community, then in the gay communities in San Francisco and Los Angeles. Now it's been detected in Haitian refugees. No one knows why. And in heavy drug users, especially in New York City. No one knows why. And in some people with hemophilia, a disease that prevents blood clotting so the patient needs frequent blood transfusions. Why? At the Center for Disease Control in Atlanta, where 400 cases have been reported, a special task force has now been set up. One possibility, a rare herpes virus may attack the body's immune system, bringing with it the cancer or a lethal form of pneumonia.
By finding the cause of this, we may be able to dissect out that part of the immune system that prevents cancer in general.
And there are more whys. Why just certain geographic areas? Why just certain groups? And most frightening, the possibility that the virus can be transmitted from person to person, virtually a contagious form of cancer. Specialists argue that millions of dollars should be spent for research now.
What we can learn from this group of individuals about cancer in general, how it's transmitted, what causes it, and hopefully how to stop it, is absolutely unbelievable.
But there is almost no money being spent so far. One New York group is raising a few thousand dollars for research by selling t-shirts.
What did the spots look like?
In San Francisco, a Kaposi sarcoma hotline opens, supported by private donations. Bobbi Campbell spends one morning a week at the hospital for chemotherapy for a disease that, at the moment, has not spread.
When I came down with this disease, I found this button, and it absolutely reflected my position. You know, I may be down, but I'm not out.
For Bobbi Campbell, it is a race against time. How long before he and others who have this disease finally have answers, finally have the hope of a cure? Barry Peterson, CBS News, San Francisco.